Good evening. I'd like to welcome to the Crockett City Council meeting. It's Monday, August 5th, 6 p.m. Thank you all for being here. Councilman Larry Robbins will be absent this evening. We're going to begin our meeting, as we always do, with an invocation and the Pledge of Allegiance. I've asked our Mayor Pro Tem Bill Holcomb to lead us in that, so if you can, please rise.
Almighty God, Heavenly Father, send down upon those who hold office within the city of Crockett the spirit of wisdom, charity, and justice, that with steadfast purpose that they may faithfully serve their offices to promote the well-being of all people. Renew the ties of mutual respect which form our civic life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Make a seat. Council, and thank you to our visitors.
Great, thank you.
We're going to move on to item number three, approval of the minutes from the regular meeting dated July 15th, 2013.
Mayor, that opportunity to read those minutes, I believe they should be approved and written.
Second.
Motion made and second to approve the minutes from the regular meeting dated July 15th. All in favor, signify by usual voting sign. Motion passes 4-0 unanimous. Thank you, Council. Council, if you don't mind, we have an item number 10, consider approve appointment of a member to Crockett Economic Industrial Development Corporation Board of Directors. I've been asked by the Executive Director, Tom Lambert, if we could perhaps move that up, and I told him that we would. So if it's okay with you, we're going to move item number 10 up to this particular point here. The agenda item would be consider and approve appointment of new member to Crockett Economic Industrial Development Corporation Board. We have with us their executive director as well as the president of their board, Chris Madurnoff. Thank you for coming here, Judge and Tom. As you know, in the back of your council packet, Patsy Barney, now Patsy Stokes, has moved outside the city and according to the bylaws, could no longer serve. So their board recommendation is that we appoint Ellen McCrae, local business owner for many years here in Crockett, as new member to the Economic Development Board of Directors.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made and second that we approve Ellen to the board. All in favor, signify by usual voting sign. Motion passes unanimously. Welcome aboard. Tom?
Chris would like to say.
Yes, sir.
Just want to thank the council and you, Mayor, for filling our vacancy that we have here. We're happy to have Ellen on board with us. We're also, somewhere along the line, I want to say a really good word of thanks to Patsy for all the years. I mean, if y'all think back, either in the Chamber of Commerce or on the Development Board, I mean, she's given her all for, I don't know, 15, 20 years, and worked real hard. She chose to move outside the city. We hate to lose her, but we're excited about having Ellen. We're working, and we hope we'll have something to report to you for very long. Thank you.
We appreciate that. Thank you. Welcome aboard, Ellen. Thank you for your willingness to serve. And again, as the judge said, nobody's put their heart and soul into this community, Houston County and the city of Crockett, more than Patsy Barney Stokes. So she definitely deserves a debt of gratitude. And I know y'all will be giving her a plaque. I think you told me, Tom, at your next meeting. So thank y'all. We appreciate it. Thank you, Council. Let's move on to the Police Department report. Police Department Manpower and Criminal History report for July 2013. Chief Cross, welcome, Chief.
Thank you, Mayor, City Council Member, City Administrator. This is the report for July for the police department. We had a total of 16 officers. They worked 2,598 manpower hours. They answered 522 calls during that month. They made 29 total arrests. They issued 79 traffic citations, 38 of those were warnings. They took 166 total reports for the month. They worked 9 traffic accidents and answered 36 alarm calls. There's a breakdown of the criminal reports below there if you have any questions about those.
Any questions for the chief?
Something on a positive note, it looks like the false alarms seem to be coming down slowly but surely.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chief.
All right, thank you.
Appreciate you. Thank you for your report. Council, if you will, let's move on to the fire department report and monthly incident activity and status report for June and July. Chief Angerstein, welcome, Chief.
Mayor, Council, Ms. Thompson, have the activity and status report for June and July. If you will, I'd go through June. I gave you the package which has both reports in it. For the city, a total of 33 calls for the month of June, one being a structure fire, one vehicle fire, two grass fires, one trash fire, six accidents, two accidents with rescue extrication, nine power line emergencies, one gas leak and one hazmat spill, and four first responders. False alarms, business, three. And one investigation, and also one terrorist threat. For July in the city, structure fires none, two trash fires, six vehicle accidents, 12 power line emergencies, two trees down, two gas leaks, seven first responders, and one business false alarm.
Pretty busy, Chief.
Yes, sir. Within the county, for the month of June, I'll have 11 total. Two vehicle fires, three grass fires, one trash fire, two vehicle accidents with extrication, one power line emergency. And for the month of June, I have 18 total, three being structure fires, residential, seven grass fires, one trash fire, two vehicle accidents with rescue, one oil well fire, and one first responder call. For the month of June, 44 calls total. We have 24 firefighters positions filled. For the month of July, 50 calls total. 24 firefighters. Are there any questions?
Any questions, Council?
Thank you, Chief.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your report. Council, at this time, we're going to move on to item number six, which is discussion of the fiscal year 2014 budget issues. I hope you've had some time to go through this. I know some of you have been quite busy in the last few days, and I wondered if there was any questions or comments about the things we talked about the last two meetings where we got to hear the capital requests from our department heads. I spent some time working with Mitzi and with Curtis, and maybe some of you as well have, and going through some budget issues. As you know, we have a lot of capital requests this year, probably more so than we've had in many years. And over the years, we've done our best, I think, to patch and patch and patch. And as a result of that, we have an incredible amount of money that we spend every year on maintenance issues. And so, it's my opinion that we're going to have to replace some of the equipment in the city. There were a lot of capital requests that were made. Just based on what we saw, I asked Ray to put together a financing package of some of the capital requests. And I just kind of give council an idea about that before we go into the aspect of the proposed tax rate change. As you know, the police department was asking for three Tahoes for their department. The fire department was asking for an engine. We had a front end loader that was requested, a sewer machine, a tractor out in solid waste, as well as a truck to pick up the recycling. I asked Brock Ray to put together a list and get some financing quotes. Basically, with all of those pieces of equipment, with one police car, Chief, instead of three this year, since I see that you're getting hopefully getting one on the grant program as well. Anyway, Ray put together a total amount of about $252,000 in lease equipment with a lease payment amount for 4 years, four annual payments of about $66,000. If we spread it out to 5 years, would be about $54,000. Frankly, the only way we're going to be able to afford these capital requests is to increase our effective tax rate. And in your council package, you have a sheet that Mitzi put put together that goes over our tax rates, if you will, the 2013 rate, the effective rate, and then the rollback rate. The rollback rate is a tax rate, the highest amount that the city council can approve without there being a potential rollback petition in election. That's a pretty well, good way to put that. Council, what, any discussion or question about the tax rate or anything I've mentioned regarding some of the capital improvement requests?
Only comment I got, Mayor, I mean, I would like maybe if Ray or Mitzi works through those all these capital requests and maybe prioritize them, score them 1 to 10 on necessity. I mean, just because everybody's asking, I mean, we don't have to go out and take a big note and give everybody what they want. We need to, I'd like to see it prioritized, most important piece of equipment, and maybe make us a list from 1 to, and work down the list, and give us a target as...
I think they basically have done that, Councilman. I really...
Okay, I just haven't seen it.
Well, Ray, you may have some comment about that, but I, you know, we hashed through all of these requests and tried to prioritize them, as you said, of what was maybe termed something that was urgent, you know, that we really couldn't do without, and then something that perhaps that we might could put on the back burner. And I think that's pretty much what we've done with the list. Did you have some items that you thought might not be on the priority?
No, I just thought we, you know, maybe they could be scored. I mean, if we give everybody whatever department wants this year, then what's going to happen to us next year? I mean, I think we need to be approach it with caution.
Absolutely, I agree with you, Ray. You have a comment?
Mayor, Council, Ms. Thompson. Councilman, we did do that as far as grading on 1 to 10. I don't know about that, but we had several other request items that are not on that list. Mitzi and I have been spending hours and hours trying to figure out in different scenarios how we could, when we start from the top, where we could get everything that we needed. The department heads were real good and did a lot of research on their equipment that they requested. And I mean, they truly do, in, you know, need those things as far as they're concerned. So all we could really do is, the mayor's request was come up with different scenarios on the financing, which we've been working on that for about 2 weeks now, as well as the police chief has and the fire chief.
So what are some of the things that we weren't thinking we were gonna be able to fund this year?
You know, I told you we could probably take that recycle truck off, which is $30,000. We really need it, but when we started prioritizing, I said, well, you know, we could take that off if we had to. We'll just live with what we have. We took off a mower, one of the zero-turn mowers, which one of the councilmen asked me not to, but I did anyway, because we prioritized on that list that you're talking. Councilman Donalds, we're just at a point right now that we've been doing this every year and every year and every year, and, you know, not buying this stuff, and it's finally caught up to us. And we're just throwing good money down the drain right now, as far as I'm concerned, on our maintenance. It's skyrocketing.
If you look back on your council packet from the previous meeting, Councilman, I don't know if you have that or not, but there's a list, basically, of those capital requests. There's 1, 2, 3. There's about 14 requests there, from everything from the equipment that we talked about, to redoing the parking lot at the fire department, to a pay increase for the police department, to foundational repairs, engineer work and stuff. A lot of that didn't make the cut for the stuff that we asked Ray to finance, to try to look for a financing package.
So there is a list of what we're going to try to finance.
Yes.
Yeah, actually,
it's in the.
Exactly.
Now that's just a proposed list. I just got that at 5:30 from the finance office.
It doesn't give you probably a good description. You know, the last meeting, I think we had a pretty good, and I guess the first meeting too, we had a pretty detailed description of the different items that we need as far as. Technical descriptions, et cetera. That's just basically a list, but.
And keep in mind, Councilman Dunn, that does not include the Chief Angustine did his own research on that and got finance, and he did a pretty good job on that. Got a real good interest rate. And so we didn't think it was necessary to go out for financing on the truck since he'd already done it.
Yeah, and the other thing too, Council, is we're not approving our budget tonight. We really need to try to set a tax rate that we can begin the process of starting our public hearings according to the state. And so you say to yourself, what's the basis for setting that tax rate? You know, is it that we are going to set it what we've done in the past and not try to recuperate any other financing in the city for capital improvements and other things that are broken down, or do we take it to the level of rollback? I noticed that the county this year has taken it to the rollback level, and it's been a bit of a painful process. I know they're going through that at this point. Councilman, you have something?
We've had so much. We've patching repaired. We basically got a lot of junk out there. We've got to start somewhere getting it replaced, because it's not just the cost of what it is to replace it, but we've got people that are idle or not turning out their maximum efficiency because they're sitting around with broken down systems. And then I agree with what we need to do. We really can't make decisions about all right, we're going to try it. Do we know income is going to fix it? That's not what it is. We're at the point right now that we need to know how much money we have to spend and how we're going to fit it into.
I think I figured our maintenance budget is costing us a little over $100,000 a year in all the major departments in the city, vehicle maintenance, I should say. And I don't think by purchasing these equipments you're going to be able to wipe all of that out, but I do think it's a step in the right direction that you will be able to save some.
118.
Okay. So I would expect that at least 20% of that, maybe 30%. That we can save on that maintenance budget when we start the process of trying to acquire some better equipment.
Well, I would hope it would be a bigger number than that if that's the way we go. And looking back at some of the larger item things that we have spent toward maintenance, if the year coming is any, this current year is any indication of what we might be spending out next year, I think it's a pretty safe bet that we'll exceed half, if not a good bit more. And it's a catch 22 that nobody likes to be in. I think that the department heads, personally, my take on the last meeting, the department heads did their homework. It was probably the most well-organized, I won't say bare bones, but the request and the way it was approached looked to me to be, needs, not as much luxuries. I mean, matter of fact, I didn't see much in the way of a luxury. These are needs for the most part. We just have to figure out, do we want to stay where we are, or do we want to try to move forward with the quality of life and try to change the way we've been doing things instead of reacting to problems, be a little bit more proactive. And it's a tough pill to swallow.
Chief, you have a comment?
Yeah, I can just briefly. We don't have a vehicle. Our average mileage on a vehicle is 130,000 miles. We don't have a vehicle with less than 100,000 miles on it right now. I mean, y'all come by our department, you see what our vehicles look like. We're going to spend probably between $25,000 and $30,000 on vehicle maintenance in our department alone this year. I think the figures we had for the three Tahoes was the first year you wouldn't have to pay anything this year for the three Tahoes, it's deferred, and you would pay $35,000 for the next 4 years. Well, if you're spending $25,000 to $30,000 to keep these pieces of equipment up, I mean, another $5,000, there's your vehicle payment for the three new Tahoes. They come with great warranties also, so that they would be taken care of for the first year or 2 years on certain parts of those equipment, so you wouldn't have any maintenance fees at all for those new vehicles. And it would drastically cut down the vehicle maintenance for the existing cars we have here, because those four cars, three plus the one with the grant, they're going to hit the roads and go in service. So I just want to bring that to your attention so you can be aware of that.
I good comment. And I think it would decrease their maintenance, vehicle maintenance budget some degree. Although we do have some older vehicles that we're going to have to maintain for some length of time till we can continue.
Two or three that we can get rid of if we get that number of vehicles and take them off the streets and sell those and try to put the money back to the general fund too, so.
Maybe would, you know, replace some of those maintenance hogs that we've got out there.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Any other, I mean, our business tonight, council, is just budget discussion, and then the next item will certainly be to consider and approve a tax rate and our public hearing schedule. So we still have some time to hash out our budget and make those requests known, what you feel like we should do with the budget before it's approved in the first week in September. Any other comments or questions about the budget or the capital request? Okay, we're going to move on to consider and approve proposed tax rate and proposed public hearing schedule. I propose that we go up to the rollback rate. It's been, I think 2008 was the last time we took any kind of an increase with regard to tax rate. Any other discussion regarding the...
It wasn't the rollback rate then.
No, we didn't even take it up to the rollback. Good point.
I'll move we accept the mayor's recommendation.
I second.
Motion made and second that we set our tax rate at, was it 5.4, 514? All in favor signify by use your voting sign. All opposed? Motion passes 3-1. Thank you, council. If you'll also notice, where is our public hearing schedule? There we go. Just a reminder, the state requires us to have two public hearings regarding the tax rate. The first public hearing will be August 19th. The second one will be August 26th. And hopefully by September 3rd, which is a Tuesday after Labor Day, we can approve our ad valorem tax rate as well as our budget. So thank you, council, for moving through that.
We need a resolution on that one to accept.
We have a motion to accept the resolution for the...
I'm not sure what...
Resolution adopting the public hearing schedule.
Oh, second.
Motion made second that we approve our public hearing schedule of August 19th, August 26th, and approval of the tax rate on September 3rd. All in favor, signify by your voting sign. Thank you, council. Appreciate it. Council, this time we're going to move on to item number 8. Consider and approve resolution of City Council, Mayor of the City of Crockett, adopting certain Section 3 policies associated with Community Development Block grant funds. Missy, can you just tell us briefly what this is all about? I know there's a lot of information in our council packet about it.
This is a requirement of HUD that any time the city gets federal funds, that we have to adopt this policy stating that we will make every effort to hire Section 3. Low-income housing.
Okay.
And once this is passed, then it's good for all of our grants. We just have to do it one time.
Okay. So moved.
Second.
Motion made and second. We approve the resolution adopting certain Section 3 policies associated with community development block grants. All in favor, signify by use your voting sign. Motion passes unanimously. 4-0. Thank you. Item number 9, consider to approve authorizing Deputy City Administrator Ray Fleming to purchase new floor for solid waste walking floor trailer. Ray, it might do you a little bit just to make an explanation regarding the walking floor trailer. It's something that's unique to solid waste. And so I'll give you the floor, sir.
Okay, thank you, Mayor. Council, Ms. Thompson. Council, what I'd like you to consider and hopefully approve is a new walking floor for the walking floor trailer at solid waste. And for those that don't know what it is, basically that's how we transfer solid waste from Crockett to Jacksonville. That's what the landfill's at. It's a 53-foot trailer, and it's got 24 53-foot long aluminum tracks that actually walk the solid waste to the back of the truck. So it semi-compacts it. They bought that trailer in 2007, mainly because the garbage trucks were going to the landfill at the time. They do their pickup and then they go into the landfill, which is not a very productive way to do business. It's not cost effective at all, so they bought the trailer in 2007 and we can get three garbage trucks into the trailer and then Rodney goes to the landfill. So approximately 3 to 4 times a week, it goes to the landfill. However, when they purchased the trailer, they were told the solid waste director at the time that if we got 5 to 7 years out of the trailer, we were doing good. For the simple fact that we're moving solid waste. And so you can imagine what's in there and what it does to the aluminum tracks, all of the valves that are underneath that we've had to replace. Anyway, long story short, we've already turned the floor once 3 years ago, had it turned, now it needs to be replaced. The cost to replace that is right at a little less than $18,000. $17,400 if they don't run into problems, $18,000 worst case scenario. This is it's a safety issue, it's a TCQ issue. If Ronnie gets stopped going to Jacksonville, with the amount of juice that's leaking out of the bottom of it, he could be fined big time. If TCQ comes and does an inspection, and they will check that walking floor trailer, and they see it leaking, we're gonna get fined big time. So it's a safety issue, it's a, you know, a financial issue, and it's just to do the right thing, we need to do it.
It's a sealed trailer, right?
It's sealed with gaskets and seals, yes sir. And basically all the seals and gaskets are completely rotted through. The juice is literally just dripping between the slats.
Do you have funds in your budget or in contingency?
Yes, we do, in our existing budget right now.
Sorry?
We have it in our existing budget, 2013 budget. But we wanted to bring it to council just to let you know, because it's a high dollar item, that we're not just going out and spending money without letting y'all know. So.
TCEQ yes. Fine, and then we still have nothing to show for it. I'd like to move to be approved.
I second. Motion made second. Any other discussion?
One thing to note, you know, and it took some educating on my part. When I read through my budget over the weekend, I was rather shocked at that kind of a number for a 53-foot trailer when I know what your average box trailer should run. But he enlightened me. I didn't realize that, you know, all the components, and the fact that this trailer does the job of three to four times a week. So it's cutting back roughly a third of the trips on our truck that's pulling the trailer. And it's just much more efficient. And
because it compacts as it walks, and then you get a lot more material.
It'll walk all the material toward the front of the truck. And it doesn't completely compact it, but it semi-compacts it. And without the walking floor, there's no way we could load the trash in there. There's no way to get it all the way to the back. Mm. Those trucks, brand new, I did a little research. $106,000 for a new one. City Crockett paid $90,000 for that in 2007. And they go up and up every year. So we're hoping that this new floor will give us 3 to 4 more years. Talking to Keith Kaler, who owns the company Wilkins, where we bought this, he said we're already at our limit right now. He said, if that thing, you buy a new one today, you did good, because we've had it 6 years. He said, because we're hauling solid waste.
So what's a brand new trailer cost?
$106,000.
Wow.
So I think that's, we already replaced all the valves about 6 months ago underneath that were completely rotted through. We sent it to San Antonio. We spent about $20,000-$25,000 on that. So we're good down there. We're good underneath, but we gotta take care of the floor. If we take care of the floor, I think we can get 3-4 more years out of it.
Okay. We have a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor of the purchase of the walking floor trailer, floor, I guess you call it, right?
Yes.
All in favor, signify by using your voting sign. Motion passing unanimously. Thank you, Trey. Thanks for the explanation. Council, we're going to move out of number 11 now, and there are several tax trust properties listed in your council packet. Consider and approve bids on the following tax trust properties. I'm going to read them. does, for the record, suit 07-00844 parcels, suit 09-0042, suit 080213, suit 080203, suit 060082, suit 000035, suit 050235, suit 060169, suit 060295, suit 070081, suit 070295, suit 100152, suit 050107, and last but not least, suit 99A254T. This will actually get these properties back on the tax roll. They're just listed in no particular order, but I hope that we can just get them all approved in one fell swoop if we can, Council.
So moved.
Second. Motion made and second to approve the tax trust properties that I refuse to read again. All in favor, signify by your usual voting sign. Motion passes unanimously. Thank you, Council. I know Bradley bought quite a few of those. He's getting into the land business. Thanks, Council. We have one request to speak, Perry Elam. Give you a few minutes, Mr. Elam. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, Council, staff. First of all, I want to give kudos to Chief Cross and his department. They've done an outstanding job. I want to say publicly, thank you. Outstanding job at the Martin Luther King area, trying to help us clean up the area and do some things. Again, thank you for the weekend. Thank you for extra manpower. Appreciate it. Thank you. A couple of things real quick is Councilman Robbins had mentioned a few months ago about trying to get the city charter before the council. There's some concerns that not only he had, but some of the community folks have, and I even have some of those concerns. I was wondering when would that be on the agenda so it can be discussed. The second thing I wanted to bring up real quickly is that in your city council meetings, you know, it's always the public speaks after everything has been passed. It seems to me that maybe you might want to just think about this, that some input from the city citizenry, before you vote unanimously on different projects, that the citizen has to input. Those are my two main concerns. The city charter is one of my main concerns because there's some things going on that the citizens have come to me about. We looked at, and I'm sure Councilman Robbins has some questions. Wondering when that will be on the agenda, and when can the citizens at least come before this body and speak on their concerns. Thank you.
Appreciate you. Thank you for being here, sir. Council have any input, any comment or question? Thank you all for being here then. Appreciate you. Thank you for all the audience being here. Nothing else? Meeting adjourned.